After Bhagavan Rama, if there is anyone who is worshipped and has become beloved, it is Hanuman. He is seen as a unique embodiment of heroic Shakti, which is power and strength, and Bhakti, which is devotional love towards Bhagavan Rama. In later literature, he is seen as the deity of martial arts, such as wrestling, acrobatics, and even meditation, and also very diligent scholarship. From the first meeting itself, the admiration of Sri Rama and Hanuman for each other was evident. Sri Rama and Lakshmana reached the Pampa lake and were spotted by Sugriva. Suspecting that his elder brother Vali had sent these men to kill him, Sugriva was frightened. Although dressed in the bark of trees, he recognized them to be distinguished warriors. Hanuman, the minister to Sugriva, the king in exile, was sent to ascertain their intentions and also appraise them of Sugriva. Hanuman assumes the form of a sadhu and approaches Sri Rama and Lakshmana and addresses them. How have you two sadhus of remarkable vigor, unfailing prowess, austere vows, and excellent appearance, resembling a couple of royal sages or gods, come to this region, causing fright to the herds of deer, while surveying the trees and lending charm to the lake of sparkling water? Who are you, of charming arms and remarkable fortitude, clad in the bark of trees and possessing a lustrous face? Hanuman continues with his soft, pleasing words in praise of them as he is trying to ascertain who they really are. He is also very quick to grasp that they are not at all a source of danger and decides to drop his guard and reveal the truth about his king, Sugriva, seeking friendship. So impressed is Sri Rama with Hanuman's words that he cheerfully tells Lakshmana, "Blessed is Sugriva who has a minister like Hanuman whom I was seeking. Hanuman knows how to speak and can tame enemies. To speak in the way he has done is only possible for one who has studied the Rig Veda with meaning, the Yajur Veda and the Sama Veda. Surely the entire range of grammar has been studied by him in many ways. Nothing has been wrongly worded by him, even though he has spoken a good deal. No fault of expression was noticed anywhere in his face, nor his eyes, nor his forehead, nor his eyebrows, nor in any one of his limbs. The speech emanating from his chest and articulated by his throat is unambiguous, unfaltering, and does not grate, uttered in a modulated tone. His remarkable speech is grammatically correct, fluent, and delightful to the mind. Even the mind of an enemy, with his sword uplifted, will be made friendly." After sharing their life story up to the separation from Sita, they tell Hanuman that indeed they too were looking for Sugriva for his help, and Hanuman delightfully takes them there. After hearing Hanuman's report of how he reached Lanka, located Sita, and shared Rama's message with her, Sri Rama is most delighted. In the Yuddha Kanda 1-6, he says that a great work, rare on earth, has been done. Hanuman has manifested his strength in proportion to his courage in this way. He talks about some types of servants. Servant is the one who serves and not someone who is lowly or inferior, as the commonly understood meaning goes. Sri Rama says, they speak of that servant as the foremost among men, who when entrusted by his master with a duty difficult to perform, does much more than what he's assigned. The other type of servant is a mediocre person who, though qualified and capable, accomplishes only some part of the work. The third type of servant is such a person who, though qualified and capable, does not do the work. While extra work was done by Hanuman, no dishonor was brought to his own self. Through the discovery of Princess Sita, the entire race was saved from destruction. Sri Rama says, "It bothers me that I cannot show my kindness worthy of Hanuman. This embrace, which is all that I can call my own, is unreservedly offered to this Mahatma, Hanuman." Saying so, he embraced Hanuman. This is a very beautiful moment when Sri Rama expresses his gratitude to Hanuman. We see Rama's eagerness in gratitude and also recognizing that an act of love and service can never be fully compensated, and that gratitude is not an impatience of settling an account or trying to free oneself from an obligation. In the service of Sri Rama, no task was too large or difficult for Hanuman. He literally moved a mountain when the Sanjeevani herb was urgently required to save Lakshmana's life. By choosing to take the entire mountain, he left no possibility of error or waste of time. Although Vali and Ravana's might was incomparable, it was not equal to the strength of Hanuman. Shauryam, Dakshyam, Balam, Dhairyam, courage, skills, agility, strength, forbearance had taken their abode in Hanuman. Before the war, perceiving the army of monkeys sinking into despondency at the very sight of the sea, Hanuman was quiet. He had to be reminded of his strength by Jambavan, the aged Vanara. Vanara is a humanoid which is monkey-like, but not a monkey. So Jambavan, the aged Vanara, tells him, "O warrior, learned as you are in all branches of knowledge, why are you sitting silent and apart? You are equal to Sugriva. You are almost equal to Rama and Lakshmana. As a child, you had imagined the rising sun to be a fruit and flew towards it in order to pluck it. Seeing your effortless and fearless flight, Indra hurled his thunderbolt at you. Struck by it, your right jaw was broken. Enraged by this, your father, the wind god, Vayu, stopped his movement and stood still. Everyone became breathless, and all the gods begged Vayu to lay aside his anger, and they came forward to bless you. You would be equal to the wind god in splendor, intelligence, and power. Death would come to you at your will, and no weapon could slay you." After being reminded of his power and strength, the mighty armed Hanuman leapt across the sea, covering 100 yojanas or 800 miles. Very often, we too need reminders of the Shakti that we have been blessed with. After overpowering the Rakshasas presiding over the city of Lanka, Sita was discovered and spoken to as well and comforted by Hanuman. Hanuman's service to Rama had its moments of pain and insult. He allowed himself to be bound and taken prisoner in Lanka. He was paraded around the city, and the citizens were given the opportunity to kick him. In the battle, the leaders of Ravana's army, the sons of his ministers, his own servants and son, all of these were struck down by Hanuman single-handed. Lanka was reduced to ashes. When we reflect on Hanuman's service, there are important questions that come to mind. What is the source of his extraordinary motivation, the strength and enthusiasm that he brings to his work? What helped him to put up with the humiliation and to strive against all odds. Surely it was not material reimbursement, since he neither requested nor received any such reward from Rama. Yet his work brought him great joy, meaning and fulfillment. When Sri Rama asks him, "What service can I do for you in return?" he replies, "Everything is attainable by your grace." And further says, "Love for you is the source of the greatest happiness. Please grant me unending love." To these heartfelt and sincere words, Sri Rama says, "So be it." In these two lines, we understand the purpose of Hanuman's work. Love for Sri Rama expressed itself in the willingness to serve. The dedication and sacrifices of parents for children, of husbands and wives for each other and their children, the patriots for their countries, and those who care for the poor and the suffering are all inspired by love. Of course, the salary, pension benefits, vacations, bonuses, and stock options are also important. Yet, work, if not motivated by love, will not continue to be fulfilling. Those whose work is inspired by the fullness of love have that rare energy, commitment, and enthusiasm to do whatever it takes. The thing about love or bhakti, as in Hanuman's case, is that it provides its own immediate satisfaction. The reward is continuous and continues to gladden the heart. Hanuman has understood the connection between love, happiness, and the desire to serve. Bhagavan Krishna in the Gita tells Arjuna, "Yat karoshi yadashnasi, yat juhosi dadasi yat, yat tapasyasi kaunteya, tat kurushva madarpanam." Meaning, whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever ritual you perform, whatever you give, whatever religious discipline you follow, please do it as an offering to me. This understanding of an offering of love transforms our attitude, our work, our home, the clinic, the factory, the streets, all become a place of worship. We express our love to Bhagwan in contributing to our families and societies. Why did Hanuman not ask Sri Rama to bless him with love and compassion for all beings? Perhaps that is an even more noble desire. The reason is that the love of God implies and includes the love for all beings. Sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishtaha. Bhagwan himself says that I am present in the hearts of all beings. And so where is it that God is not? However we choose to relate, whether it be Sri Rama, Krishna or Devi, surely, it's not possible to love God and exclude His creation, which is His divine manifestation. Through Hanuman's life of service to Bhagavan Rama, we see that power and strength is worth its while when used to serve the cause of Dharma. In recent times, servant-style leadership is spoken of in management circles, which is really a willingness to serve the cause. Your clients, your customers, a willingness to serve your students, doing what needs to be done. And so now we have a role model and a source of blessing in Hanuman. It is said that when Sri Rama asks Hanuman how he relates to him, Hanuman said, "Deha buddhya tu dasoham, jiva buddhya tvadamshakaha, atma buddhya tvamevaham, iti me nischita matihi." When I identify myself with my body, I am your dasaha, servant. When I consider myself a jiva, an individual, I am a part of you. But when I see myself as the atma, I am indeed you. This wisdom of Hanuman granted him the freedom to play any role, including the role of a human being, and a dasaha, a servant, a devotee. My prayers that we remember and use our Shakti to serve the cause of Dharma. May our increasing love for Bhagavan include our love, care, and contribution to all beings. Siyavara Ramachandra ki jai, Bolo Hanuman ki jai, Bolo Sabasantan ki jai.